Hi, this is Rob of Precision Zone, and I'm going to be showing you how to get rid of an A00 or an A81 alarm on a Yaskawa Sigma I series of drives. Now, these two alarms are corresponding to either something being wrong with the encoder capacitors or quite possibly maybe the battery. And also, if you have replaced the battery or recently replaced your servo motor, you are going to probably get these alarms and you're going to have to clear them in order for you to be back up and running. How might you even know if you have a 15-bit absolute encoder installed on your motor? Is by the nameplate. It's going to read SGMG for Sigma 1. There will be a dash, then the kilowatt size. The next letter will be a voltage rating, and then the fourth letter will be what denotes the encoder. In this case, it's a S, and so that denotes that it's a 15-bit encoder. If it says W, that means it's a 12-bit absolute encoder, and this procedure's not gonna work. One more thought is that this procedure normally never works on the first time, so don't be discouraged if you have to repeat it 2 and 3 times. Now, if it's more than like 4 or 5, you're gonna wanna go ahead and give us a call so we can figure out what's going on. So you can see on our digital keypad that we are getting an A81 alarm, and that is due to because this is the first time this motor and drive combination have been connected together. So now let's go ahead and go through the resetting procedure so we can get this alarm cleared and get our machine back up and running. The first thing that we're gonna have to do is power off the machine. And we're going to disconnect the feedback connector from the encoder. Now, what you're going to have to do for this 17-pin style of connector is short between R and S. And R and S are these two pins right here, 1 and 2. If you see the keyway, there's kind of a 5 pins in a star pattern. The bottom two are R and S. And you need to short those two together for at least 2 minutes. You can use a simple piece of wire to do that, but unfortunately 2 minutes is a long time when you're trying to hold it there. The best way that we do it here at Precision Zone is with a simple alligator clip. You can set it on there, wait 2 minutes, and forget about it. So the 12 and the 15 pin connectors are really common as well. And on this 15-pin connector, you're going to be shorting pin 13 and 14 together. And again, you'll have to be doing this for at least 2 minutes. And this 12-pin connector is popular as well, and you'll be shorting pins 9 and 12. Again, for a full 2 minutes. Well, our 2 minutes is up, so let's go ahead and pull our jumper wire off. And before we reconnect the 17-pin connector, I do want to also mention that it is technically possible to short these capacitors through the CN2 connector here, but it is extremely difficult and it is highly unrecommended that you try. It's just better to gain access to where the motor is at. Now that we're all hooked up, let's go ahead and turn power back on. And hey, look at that. We're back to P0 and we have cleared our alarm. Well, let's go ahead and make sure this motor works. Okay, great. Well, it looks like we have successfully fixed this alarm. Now, these three connectors are the most common, and you might encounter one that's a little bit different. At that point, please reach us at Precision Zone for more help. And as always, with more troubleshooting, you can find us on the web at precisionzone.com, where there you can find our number to contact us. Thanks for watching.